So today we're going to talk about what they don't tell women about wearing makeup, okay? The first thing you need to know is that the skin is a human sponge, okay? It's like a little sponge, and it absorbs things, okay? So everything you put on your skin goes directly right in. I mean, think about the last time you used hand lotion, right? You put all this lotion on your hands and then it disappears. Where did it go? It went right inside. An average female will absorb 4 pounds and 6 ounces of chemicals every single year. So here's an example of 4 pounds. Okay, of course, probably eat a lot more sugar than that per year, but this is 4 pounds, right? This is how much chemical goes into your body through the skin every year. That's a lot. And there's about 515 different chemicals put on your skin every single day, from hairspray, blush, foundation, shampoo, conditioners, deodorant, like aluminum, for example, body lotions, hand cream, eyeshadow, lipstick, nail polish remover, which is very, very toxic, perfumes, fake tans, all sorts of things that you're exposed to on a daily basis. Here's the problem. Some of these chemicals are carcinogens. Those are things that can cause cancer. The problem is there's always a delay between cause and effect. You start accumulating these chemicals, you don't know when potentially you could have a problem down the road. So it's really hard to connect the dots. Some of these chemicals are neurotoxins that go into the brain and the nervous system. And then there are other things called endocrine disruptors, which are things in the environment, chemicals that mimic estrogen. And so they affect the different endocrine glands like the thyroid, the pancreas, the thymus, the adrenal gland, the ovary. All these chemicals create damage on the inside, which then affects the outside, okay? And then you need more makeup to cover up all the blemishes and the dry skin and the unhealthy look. So what I want to talk about is the liver first, because your liver is probably going to take the brunt of it, the stress of it, because your liver is constantly getting rid of these poisons. It's dismantling them through a process called phase 1, phase 2 detoxification. And what that means is that your liver can take poisons, which are sometimes fat soluble, and change them into harmless particles, which are water soluble. Okay, and that all happens to the liver. So you're about as healthy as your liver. So if all these chemicals are going in, we need to talk about how to get them out. Okay, so let's talk about what to do about this. Number one, you want to evaluate what your body's being exposed to, each one of these, okay, and then replace them. Go to the health food store and start having some blush and foundation that's actually more natural, less toxic. Yes, it's going to be a little more expensive, but it's going to be very healthy for you in the long run. Make sure your lotion, for example, maybe it's a base of coconut oil and it doesn't have some of those other chemicals and alcohol in it. We want to do a detox using cruciferous vegetables. Now, this is going to also help your liver break down these poisons, okay? Cruciferous vegetables are things like kale, broccoli, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, bok choy, arugula, collard greens, radish, watercress. These are very unique vegetables that help to naturally detoxify without giving you that detoxification effect. Plus, it's going to give you a lot of nutrition. It's going to make your skin look really great, and it's going to help your liver. You want to do intermittent fasting. This is very, very, very important, because intermittent fasting is basically a physiological vacation from constantly eating all the time. It gives your organs a chance to rest and heal and repair. So intermittent fasting triggers something called autophagy. Okay, what does that mean? Autophagy is like kind of comparable to a self-cleaning oven, where your body is recycling all these things that it doesn't need and damaged proteins and microbes and chemicals, and it recycles all this stuff and it gives you new tissue. So when you do intermittent fasting, it helps in the cleaning and repair of the chemicals and the damage that the chemicals have created. Very, very therapeutic, especially for your skin. Number four, we want to make sure that we eat enough fat, okay? Do not do a low-fat diet, okay? If you want to actually help your skin has a layer of fat, and so we want to replace that fat with healthy fat from healthy fish, like salmon, wild-caught salmon, coconut oil, seafood, healthy nuts, seeds, olive oil, avocado. Very important to start adding more fat, because if you're on a low-fat diet, that's going to inhibit the detoxification of these chemicals and inhibit your ability to make healthy skin. All right, guys, so there's your plan of exactly what to do. Thanks for watching. Hey, before you go, I'm going to create some new videos on food evaluation. Okay, so if you'd like to participate, I can't promise that you'll be the person that I'll choose. So here's what you're going to do. You're going to take a picture of what you're eating, a close-up, okay, of one day, how frequent you're eating, like as an intermittent fasting. Is it one meal, two meals, and anything else that you're drinking or supplements, and go ahead and add your height, weight, and age, and any major body problems that you're having. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to analyze that to see what you're doing correct and what you need to improve. All right? So go ahead and click the link down below, upload your information. And again, I can't promise that I'm going to pick you, but I'm going to pick several people and I'll do the evaluations and I'll post these as YouTube videos. All right. Talk to you later.